Common Assessment Number 4, Poetry. A Real Case by Sarah Holbrook. Doubtful. I have a fever or any other measurable symptom. I'm just down with a sniffly case or sudden self-loathing syndrome. Today, it hit like a thwop of mashed potatoes snapped against the plate. An unrequested extra serving of 4 of just for now self-hate. Today, I'm worthless. A leftover bath. A wad of secondhand gum. I belong in a twist-tied bag with the rest of the toys that won't run. My mood's as welcome as incoming dog breath or a terminal case of split ends. I sparkle like a dust rag. I could attract mosquitoes, maybe not friends. In fact, I could be contagious. I'm a downer, to say the least, and if you try to push my mood swing, I'll only drag my feet. Why? Couldn't tell you. Just some days I get up and get down. It's not a permanent disability, though. Tomorrow I'll come around. The Road Not Taken by Robert Frost. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry I could not have not traveled both. And be one traveler long I stood and looked down one as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. Then took the other as just as fair, and having perhaps the better claim, because it was grassy and wanted wear, though as for that the passing there had warned them really about the same. And both that morning equally lay in leaves no step had trodden black. Oh, I kept the first for another day, yet knowing how way leads on to way. I doubt it if I should ever come back. I shall be telling this with a sigh, somewhere ages and ages hence. Two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by. And that has made all the difference. Moco Limping by David Nava Monreal. My dog hobbles with a stick of a leg that he drags behind him as he moves. And I was a man that wanted a beautiful, noble animal as a pet. I wanted him to be strong and capture all the attention by the savage grace of his gait. I wanted him to be the first dog howling in the pack, the leader, the brutal hunter that broke through the woods with thunder. But instead, he's this rickety, little canine that leaves trails in the dirt with his club foot. He's a stumbler that trips while chasing lethargic bees and butterflies. It hurts me to see him so abnormal, so clumsy and stupid. My vain heart weeps knowing he is mine. But then he turns my way and looks at me with eyes that cry out with life. He jumps at me with his feeble paws. I feel his warm fur. And his imperfection is forgotten. Question number 1. Which lines from the poem suggest that the speaker's situation is temporary? A. Doubtful. I have a fever. B. Tomorrow I'll come around. C. Today it hit me like a thwop of mashed potatoes. D. I could attract mosquitoes. Maybe not friends. 2. What is the most likely reason that the poet uses capitalization in line 6? A. To highlight a problem that the speaker experiences. B. To stress the speaker's expectations for tomorrow. C. To indicate that the speaker's condition happens unexpectedly. D. To show the speaker's excitement about an upcoming event. Number 3. Read the following lines from the poem. And if you try to push my mood swing, I'll only drag my feet. The poet includes these lines most likely to suggest that the speaker, A. does not wish to be pushed on a swing. B, wants to deal with the situation alone. C, does not often receive help from others. D, is not physically strong. Number four, the imagery in lines 16 through 19 helps the reader understand A, the shift in the speaker's attitude, B, the speaker's unpleasantness, C, why the speaker has no friends, D, the speaker thinks of others. Number five, the poet reveals the speaker's feelings mainly by A, using similes and metaphors to describe them, B, explaining their effect on others, C, connecting them to memories, D, repeating specific words for emphasis. Read the passage, The Road Not Taken, and answer questions 6 through 8. Number 6, which lines from the poem best suggest that the speaker is realistic? A, lines 3 and 4. B, lines 9 and 10. C, lines 14 and 15. D, lines 16 and 17. Number 7, what is the most likely reason the poet uses a line break and repetition in lines 18 and 19? A, to stress the importance of the speaker's dilemma. B, to indicate the significance of the speaker's power. C, to highlight the speaker's inability to make a choice. D, to show the speaker's disappointment with the outcome. Number 8. The imagery in the first two stanzas help the reader understand A, the similarity of the paths, B, the beauty of the forest, C, the condition of the undergrowth, D, the danger of the roads. Read the passage, Moco Limping, and answers questions 9 through 13. Number 9, in the lines 1 through 5, the poet uses figurative language to A, create a vivid picture of how the dog walks, B, explain how the dog was injured, C, build a strong repetitive rhythm that continues through the poem, D, show how fit and active the dog is. Number 10. Which statement best expresses the speaker's attitude about his deal, his ideal dog, and the dog he has? A, the speaker's real dog is exactly the dog he imagined owning. B, the speaker's ideal dog is strong and powerful, while his real dog is clumsy but lovable. C, the speaker dislikes his real dog because it's embarrassing. His ideal dog would make him proud. D, the speaker's ideal dog is too brutal and howling. He would rather have a helpless dog that needs him. Number 11, the imagery in lines 31 through 34 shows that the speaker views Moco as A, quick and entertaining, B, shamefully stupid, C, clumsy even at easy tasks, D, a beautiful noble pet. Number 12, why is line 51 longer than any other line in the poem? A, because it contains the poem's most important idea, B, to retain the poem's rhythm, C, because the poet forgot to put "is forgotten" on a separate line, D, to create a pattern of rhymes at the end of lines. Number 13, Which statement best expresses the theme or message of this poem? A. High expectations are always rewarded. B. Love is more than perfection. Again, letter B. Love is more important than perfection. C. Pets reflect who we are. D. Life is full of disappointments. End of common assessment 4.